The Me Too movement has hit the photo news world. Top National Geographic photo editor Patrick Witte was terminated after allegations of sexual misconduct. In an exclusive story by Vox, the outlet reported multiple cases of harassment faced by women, ranging from unwanted advances.
Witte grabs me around the waist and plants a big wet kiss on my cheek. I'm stunned, totally mortified.
To abuses of power stretching years before his time at Nat Geo.
He was flirtatious and made me uncomfortable. He screamed, "You're never going to work for Time Magazine."
Witte was fired in December of 2017 after more than 20 women complained of sexual misconduct and HR launched an investigation. Yet Nat Geo has not gone on the record to say Witte's termination was due to accusations. We reached out to National Geographic and received no response. Witte released a statement. It said, "I am deeply sorry that some of my past behavior has been hurtful to women. With firm conviction, I deny that I've ever engaged in any behavior that amounts to sexual aggression."
Editors have so much power over photographers' lives.
Stephanie Keith was a photographer when Witte was her photo editor at the New York Times from 2003 to 2005. She says she didn't face harassment from Witte, but said,
"Photographers can be made or broken, you know, by if an editor wants to hire them, if the editor likes them. And when there's an abuse of that power relationship, then that is a complete breach of professional ethical behavior."
The Witte scandal highlights a larger issue, the lack of gender diversity in the photo news industry. Currently, men make about 72% of photographers, artists, and videographers working in news. As an example of how women are underrepresented, take a look at this. Last year, a Nikon PR campaign highlighted 32 photographers. They were all men.
You know, not only is a disproportionate percentage of our industry male, which is problematic for hiring equality reasons, for the fact that it creates naturally complicated, sexist, misogynist spaces for female news photographers, but it also means that the general public is consuming information, consuming news through a predominantly male gaze, and that's really dangerous.
Photographer Danielle Zalkman founded Women's Photograph Initiative last year. It's a Rolodex of over 700 female and non-binary photojournalists from around the world. Keith is on that list. Her name might not sound familiar, but her images are. Aside from some of the physical dangers in the field, Keith shared that women also have to deal with sexism from their subjects.
"Someone took a lit tiki torch and started shoving it into my camera, and then he said, 'You're anti-white.' The rally was extremely sexist. It was almost all men, really hopped up on adrenaline. One guy in particular singled me out and started calling me a cunt, saying, 'Oh, you probably don't have any kids because you have shriveled and dried up ovaries because you're a cunt.' The rule of journalism is that no matter what happens, you have to just stay impartial."
Keith said women behind the lens give unique perspectives. Her photograph made 2017 Best Photos of the Year for Reuters, NBC, and various outlets.
"It's important to have women as part of the conversation because they make different kinds of images. I'm so glad that people around the world are looking at this strong, beautiful African-American woman. I mean, I feel proud of that, of getting that concept out there into the world."